Here's an actual pedigree tracking bipolar disorder in an Amish family. Now, at first glance, you may think that this looks pretty familiar and may make you feel right at home. But like many complex traits, this pedigree looks different than it would for a single gene disorder. For example, if I told you to look at this pedigree and tell me if you thought the inheritance pattern was dominant or recessive, you might be inclined to say dominant if you look at the fact that the trait doesn't skip generations and affected parents do give rise to affected children. But you might also think that it's recessive. For example, over here, the trait skipped generations, and it did over here as well. And we have unaffected parents with affected children. That's typical of a recessive trait. We're actually somewhere in between. This is complex. Now to me, this pedigree indicates a more dominant inheritance pattern. Now if we assume the trait to be dominant like we learned about in lesson 5, and completely penetrant, right, that's the only kind we've talked about up to this point, then we would expect affected children to have at least one affected parent. But that's not what we saw. What we see are unaffected parents. If you thought the trait looks more recessive, we wouldn't expect it to show up in every generation like it did here. These little deviations from our normal inheritance patterns are a key indicator that there are likely multiple genetic factors, as well as environmental factors, controlling the phenotype. Whenever we find incompletely penetrant traits or alleles, this is likely what's going on.